making his way down the aisle, Sharif Rahman. The following contest is scheduled for four rounds or less in the junior middleweight division. The man keeping the order, Benji Estevez. First, fighting out of the red corner from Port-au-Prince, Haiti. Tonight, wearing the red trunks with the blue. 156 pounds. This is Vladimir, the Gladiator. From Las Vegas, Nevada. Tonight, wearing the white trunks with the red trim and officially weighing 154.8 pounds. This is Sharif Cedric Rahman.
First bout of the evening here at the 2300 Arena in Philadelphia. Mark Ammons along with the two-time Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Steve USS Cunningham.
Yes, sir.
You just actually gave the Navy thing. We're not even on camera. We're here, Sharif Rahman in the white with the burgundy and silver. Vladimir Jacinto in the red and blue. Rahman 3-0 with two knockouts, coming off a four-round Navis decision over Tylik Taylor. That was on June 29th, 2018. So he's been out of the ring for 2.5 years.
Yeah, that's a long layover, man. I mean, yet still, I see his feet, his sharpness. He's ready for this. A layover doesn't mean they're not in the gym. You know, we got to remember that.
Jacinto 0-2, stopped twice, most recently on about a year ago, January 31st, 2020. Cameron Hills stopped him in Shreveport, Louisiana. Actually, that was a card that I that's when I was a card that I actually was at Shreveport, Louisiana.
Shreveport, shout out.
Rahman, of course, the son of the former heavyweight champion of the world, Haseem Rahman. Haseem was actually supposed to join us tonight, but due to the lack of crowd allowed here tonight, just mostly essential personnel. We got five big fights, our main event tonight. Donald No Love Smith taking on William Foster III, a battle of undefeated featherweights. A real good main event. Got some interesting prospects. Sharif Rahman, one of them.
Vladimir Jacinto, he's trying to shoulder roll not that successful with it. Rotman came over the top with a straight right hand, scored a nice blow. Everybody can't be Floyd Mayweather. I mean,
Rockman just
let's keep it real.
Rockman just 24 years old. And his brother actually scored a knockout last night. Haseem Rahman Jr. scored a knockout, raised his record to 10-0.
Beautiful.
So the Rockman kids are on their way.
It's always good to see former champion sons picking up the mantle and going to work with it and being successful. You know, that's awesome.
Spoken from a man who's got two young kids in the amateurs.
Yes, yes. Cruz Cunningham and Steve Cunningham Jr.
Good body shot by Sharif Rahman.
Good slip and counter by Rotman. Ooh, nice little shove. Let's get this action going off the jab from Rotman. Leaping hook, double hook. He doubled down on that, man. That's a little bit of ring wisdom.
Quite a size differential between Rahman and Jacinto.
I mean, but look at Jacinto. He's got muscles on him. He's cut up, you know. Not saying Rotman doesn't have muscles.
There it is. Hurt.
Prepare
Fighting for the crowd. Let's keep it real. You are fighting for the crowd. The crowd brings momentum. The crowd brings excitement. Yeah, you still have an opponent. You have to get forward. You have to get out of here. So the excitement is still there. But it's just like that extra, you know, when you have tons of people seeing you and ooh-eyeing your shot.
Can you kind of get into a sparring mentality?
Well, for me, you know, personally, I can only answer that from my perspective. You know, I fought in Poland and Germany numerous times, and overseas in Poland and Germany, the fans don't clap. They don't get upset.
After the round.
Silence. Yeah, it's a silent round. So, to me, I would be comfortable. You know, I would be at home, you know, in the kitchen with my big bed. Still, a crowd cheering you, eye on your shot, giving you some emotional respect, that gives you that extra beat.
That's a good point, because I remember going over to Germany when you fought Marco Hunk.
Oh, yeah.
I was watching a fight like we do here in the States, yelling, screaming, this, that, the other. And everyone in the crowd was like looking at me like I was crazy.
Remember everybody, they were bumping us walking down the street. Oh man, I think it was because we were Americans. Vicious.
Round three scheduled for four. Sharif Rockman for the knockdown in round two.
Double jabbed his way in and committed to more combinations.
Sisto's showing a little bit more fire here in round three, trying to land a right, followed by a left hook, a little short on both ends.
Well, he has to. You know, he's down in the cards completely. This is his only shot. He's not going to outbox Rockman. He's not going to outfootwork him. He's just going to try to knock him out. One punch.
Later in the program. We will be doing this. Agreed to each call a fight with us. Derek Bozy-Ennis, right now better known son, Jerron Boots-Ennis.
Boots!
And also will be conducting an exclusive interview. He has some news for us.
This guy, Martin
Matt, toiling around the internet for the past week or so. We'll let him talk about it. Right hand, and down goes to sit down. Through the ropes, through the bottom rope. He looks like he is.
I was ready. That's it.
Get up!
Trying to beat the count. Stop
count. Straight hand. Just go back in there.
I yelled, get up.
Great.
That's
the
thing. Angry.
Move your hand. Get on it. Overhand right. Right now. Go.
Three. Close the shot. Another left hook is twice over. And Jacinto's a little upset with the phone.
I know,
for Sharif Rockman.
Here we have it, the other brother. They both get knocked out.
Good weekend to be
Rockman.
There you go.
Team Rockman.
Good performance. You know, obviously, he's had the 2 years off. Just 24 years old. And,
I like what I see in this one, man. You know, keep him building. Keep putting guys in front of him. And let him grow. And grow in the team. Have some pride. And have some hustle also. And that will bring drive. We'll see. I think we'll see some good things. At least contending for the title at the most, possibly winning.
Well, he signed, I do believe, with Greg Cohen. So, Greg had some success. Success as a father in his career. So.
That's beautiful, man. That's beautiful. Like I said, man, I'm. You know, I'm on this son picking up the mantle that their father had success at. So this is awesome.
What we're in today, no ring announcer in the ring. So Alex Barbosa is walking over to us. So let's throw it to him right from our table to give us the official time.
Where's your main camera, man?
I'm going to go to the